What up, YouTube? I am your host, Mediocre Tutorials and Reviews, back in here with one more video. All right, guys, I got this video here today. Shout out to my Instagram at Mediocre Tutorials and Reviews. It's long, but you know how to spell if you didn't. Link down in the description box down below. Now, this is one of those videos that have been sent to me an uncountable amount of time. I just haven't had the opportunity to be able to go over it. But today, we must get active. All right? I have not seen this reaction, so we're going to go over it together. Without further ado!
Mr. Henny, I understand that you are suing your ex-girlfriend. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So what happened in this lovely relationship?
5 months after we moved in together, you know, she started picking arguments with me. Like, these were different arguments, not the regular moody Denise arguments that we have, but these were different types of arguments. And she has this one friend. She actually has three friends. One of them is Maya, and the other two I bought were the Pomeranians. So
you don't have a lot of friends, Miss Henry?
I do have a lot of friends. Just the friend that I have here in court, she's been my friend since we were 9. We go back, we're like sisters.
Okay.
So she was around a lot.
Then what happened?
Uh-oh, we got a crazy lady on our hands. Notice what he said. I bought two of her friends, two Pomeranians. She's not a cat shepherd. She's a dog shepherd now. And then what does she say? I have a lot of friends. And then she said, just my one friend who I've known since 9 years old. Uh-oh, I hear delusion. Let's keep it moving.
And Mr. Henny, why are we here?
In short, it's Maya's fault. But let me tell you the story.
Okay, tell me.
So we're driving home, and she tells me that Maya saw me with another girl out in some restaurant and at a bar. And she accused me of cheating on her.
Ooh.
And mind you,
I'm going to ask, yes, because this is like a soap opera. Sometimes I feel these cases. But I'm going to ask, have you ever cheated on her?
Never.
Ever cheated on her?
I have never cheated on him.
Okay. So Maya basically puts it in Denise's ear that you are cheating with her because why?
Because she saw me 1 week and I was at a restaurant with a lady and I was also at a bar with a lady. And I mean, I also kind of want to point out that, you know, women kind of outnumber men 2-1 in this world. So a lot of times if you're out, you might just be with a lady. Like,
okay.
Maya,
why don't you get up? So you saw Richard in two different places with the same girl?
Yes, Your Honor.
And how do you know they were cheating? Or what was it about?
The single ass homegirl.
Between them that you were convinced?
The way they were pampering each other. Most likely.
What do you mean by pampering?
The girl will lean into his shoulder and he will hug her. And the times where I seen him.
Wait a minute. I'm sorry, guys. Hold on.
Shoulder and he will hug her.
That's the look of a man that's been too through it. He's tired of the bullshit. Listen, brother, you moved in with her after 5 months. Why? Or you're living with her for 5 months? Why? Why? You should be able to diagnose the crazy. All right? Let's keep it moving.
And there's times where I seen him coming out of the bar, and they gave themselves a big, huge, long hug.
Okay. The so then that to you giving each other, did you ever go up to Richard and say, hey, listen, what's going on here?
I approached him on the first time that I saw him.
Did she approach you the first time she saw you?
I don't even remember, but in her defense, Your Honor, she doesn't seem like the person that would have many friends or loved ones, so she could easily misconstrue some platonic love for romantic love.
Okay, so you didn't approach Richard and say, what's going on here? You just assumed the worst.
No, I just approached him and I told him, hi, good evening, Richard. And he looked at me surprisingly. He didn't even know I was there.
Okay. All right, so then you went home and you told Denise, or you called your girlfriend and
told me. I didn't say that the first time. I just waited because I didn't want to get into it right away. I didn't want to
get into it. So you saw him again a couple weeks later, and you told Denise
I told Denise about it.
All right, so then take it from there, Richard.
Well, so me and Denise, we're driving home, and she starts crying. And, you know, I'm still madly in love with her. And so I start to, you know, I become vulnerable. So I'm like, what's wrong? And then she tells me that, well, somebody said that you were cheating on me. Somebody. It's always somebody. Mm-hmm. I knew who somebody was right away. So, of course, I don't like her. So I got pissed. Like, you're calling me a liar. Like, that's the one thing that...
You told her, I'm not cheating on you, didn't
No,
you?
Why would I cheat
and
on you?
And you didn't believe him?
I did not believe
why
him.
Why didn't you believe him?
Just the details that Maya finally revealed to me, just saying...
What was it that Maya said that convinced that you he was...
She told me that they were very close at the restaurant and at the bar the second meeting. He picked up the tab. He was pulling her chair out. They were walking very close together, just looking like it was a first few dates with a new woman.
So then what happened? So then you guys continue arguing?
I go inside the house. She actually brings me a cup of water, and I think it was she wanted to calm me down. And I tell you, I love the lady. She's like, she's crazy, but I still love her. So she brought me some water. I drank the water. I laid down. And the next thing you know, like, I had a full head of hair. Like, I had a full set of locks. That's what actually attracted her to me. And I wake up, and there's a patch missing. Like, a patch in the top of my head. That's and I look true. Over, and I see the locks on the bed.
No.
Did you cut his dreadlocks?
I did, Your Honor.
And that's funny.
Oh, shit.
It's not funny. I understand.
What did you cut his dreadlocks with? A scissor?
I cut him with the scissors, and I cut on the back of his head where it wouldn't be very obvious.
Did you give him something to sleep?
I did.
What'd you give him?
I did give him some sleeping pills.
Some? One, two, three, four, five?
Just three.
Do you normally take sleeping pills?
I don't know. I don't need sleeping pills. I sleep pretty.
He was acting really raging.
I mean, did you read the instructions on the sleeping pill?
Did you see how many he
should have taken?
I know I didn't.
Just let me pause this real quick, because this turned from something that is just, a funny case, like we always go from time to time, to a serious crime. To a serious crime. What? You cannot give somebody a substance to change their state without that person knowing that you're doing that. And then he goes to sleep, and then you cut his hair? Because you can't handle your childlike emotions. So you try to hurt him, even though he's telling you, yo, I did not cheat on you. You then go and cut one of the reasons that you were attracted to him, his hair. Yo, the look of pain in his eyes as he was recounting that story. Dog, she, like, bump bringing her to a TV show. She gave you sleeping pills against your will. Call the cops. She needs to be in jail. She needs to be tried in front of, not on TV, but in front of a jury of her peers. Are you serious? This is the lack of accountability shit that, like, we talk about on this channel. How dare you? How dare you? Holy moly.
I don't want to hear anything from you. Why is this funny to you? It's not funny. It was just
children.
That he was in such a rage that night that
so
I...
So it was therapeutic, as you say, right?
What?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I just felt that he needed to calm down.
So what
down.
Happened? You woke up the next morning, you realized the love of your life, the woman that...
She said, I felt like he needed to calm down. So you cut his hair? Like, that's going to make him calm down more? Or the sleeping pills were supposed to make him calm down, but you didn't tell him it was sleeping pills that you put in his water? Holy, sometimes the biggest enemy in your life is underneath your own roof. Oh my God, lock away the key, all right?
You worshiped, cut your dreads off. She just admitted she gave you some sleeping pills.
I just cut a few.
I was furious. I could have done anything.
So what'd you do? Did you break up with her?
I mean, she was gone. Like, she left me this note here.
Let me see. Bernard.
Cut the hair and
she didn't even have the decency to write, like, a paragraph. It was just like a sentence.
Well, I mean, you broke my heart. I'm sorry.
Says, thanks for cheating on me.
I didn't actually break your heart.
Her
Maya broke your heart.
After cheating on her.
Well.
You were cheating on
her. Who was I with, Maya?
Okay.
With a lady. I don't even know.
Really?
I never seen her around us.
So you're suing her for $3,000?
Yes.
Okay, for...
I believe that, like, my hair, my father's hair, my grandfather's hair, like, my father and my grandfather practiced Rastafarianism. Okay. I didn't really practice it that much, but out of respect and reverence for my father, I had my hair. I've been growing my hair since I was 5 years old.
Oh.
I really feel like the $3,000 is really not even close to what it actually costs, but I really feel like something like this, there has to be some sort of repercussions.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
All right, so Renard, can you...
Dogs, since he was 5 years old, and he's got Rastas in his family in order to pay respect. Like, do you understand to cut a Rasta's hair, what they would do to you? Like, what they would do to you? And this young man was doing it out of reverence of his father and his grandfather. And you probably knew that. And you cut dreads out of his head. Disgusting. This is deplorable behavior. Absolutely.
Can you bring the witness, please?
Listen, and irrespective of whether or not he cheated or not, this is bottom feeder shit. This is abyss level shit. But at the same time, my G, I have to bring you into a little bit of accountability as well, because you know that she was crazy. She's crazy, but I love her. Yo, y'all are just, I don't understand y'all. I just don't understand y'all.
I'm an investment banker, Your Honor. Hulk Hogan was able to pull it off.
Sorry.
But I wouldn't have been able to pull it off.
I did not cut all your threads off.
She didn't call them off. You cut them off by your own choice.
Okay. Can you tell me your name, please?
Valerie.
And do you, Denise, recognize this young lady?
I do, actually.
Who is she?
This is Richard's cousin.
Okay. And Maya, who's this girl?
The lady that was with him on the bar and the dinner.
It's his cousin.
Can I ask you what was happening? Why were you out with your cousin?
I was I've been consulting my cousin for a while now because I've been having issues with my ex-husband. Mm-hmm. He cheated on me recently, so I just drove out and hung out with my cousin for a while just to kind of get away.
Mm. Anything you want to say, Denise?
I feel kind of
sorry
bad now that what I've done to him.
She can't even apologize.
I wasn't aware that it was his cousin. He never told me it was his cousin, so I was not sure of whom the woman was.
Well, he had no idea what you were talking about. You were accusing him of cheating with somebody. Who the heck was he supposed to say I'm cheating with when he wasn't cheating? Because he was actually telling the truth.
I'm really shocked that it was his cousin. He never told me that she was in town, and I just assumed that it was somebody else.
You drugged him, first of all, gave him sleeping pills that you have no idea how that would have affected him. You actually almost committed a battery on him because you touched him without his permission. You cut his hair off. You had no right to do that. Absolutely no right to do that. And you sit there now, a complete fool of yourself. You have to stop hanging out with people who are manipulative, who don't have the best interest for you, such as your girlfriend Maya, because I don't believe she does. I think that Richard did, but unfortunately, you completely ruined that. So, based on the evidence, Richard, I will grant your $3,000 claim. Good luck. I'm so sorry that this happened to you, and good luck to you, Denise.
Judge Perez has ruled in favor of the plaintiff. The defendant is ordered to pay $3,000.
Hope you learned your lesson today about assuming things.
I have learned my lesson, and I hope you can forgive me sometime.
Shut up! Hold on, let me stop the video. Whoa! I see why y'all kept sending me this video. Oh my goodness. Lock her away. Throw away the key. This is this accountability shit that we talk about in this channel from time to time, as well as the childlike behavior that you see from the opposite gender. That's that, like, how dare you? I'm absolutely floored, like, watching that. And if you notice, too, the homegirl, as soon as she figured out, wasn't it Maya, some bullshit like that? Shout out to my Mayas out there. But as soon as she knew that the girl was the cousin, she just left. All right? Stop paying attention to your single-ass homegirls. Stop listening, because they're probably hating. She could have took a photo, right, showed her the photo, and the girl would be like, oh, yeah, that's the cousin, if she really wanted to help. I mean, you saw him more than one time with the same person, with the cousin, right? Like, take a photo and show it to him if you're trying to actually help out instead of just start shit. You understand what I'm saying? Guys, I got nothing else to say after this one besides I need to take a break. Besides, I need to go take a break. You understand me? Guys, questions, comments, concerns, y'all already know what to do. Let me know in the comment box down below. Did I get this one right? Did I get it wrong? Let me know down below. But we got to go over content like this in order to more formally understand what is going on in this day and age. All right? Until next time, YouTube. Peace.